Welcome back, guys. Today we'll go to React Redux flow in depth. So why are you using Redux in React? So what is the advantage of using Redux in React? So before that, so we just sneak into this gang of four design patterns. So there's a gang of four people who developed about 23 classic design software design pattern in 1994. So it been grouped into three: structural, behavioral, and creational pattern. Creational, structural, and behavioral is a group of three. So the three groups and 23 design patterns. So this observer pattern, state pattern plays a vital role in Redux state management. So we go into observer pattern. So this is a .NET do factory. These people are expert in design patterns. Okay, so this is an observer pattern. So whenever there is a change in subject, whoever listening to the subject is gonna be notified. See, right, there's a subject, whoever listening to the subject, the observers, they're gonna be notified by subject. So we see a classic example. This is an IBM and this IBM stock. So IBM had two investors, Soros and Berkshire. So whenever there's a fluctuation in price, stock price increase and decrease, these two investors will be notified every time. That's why we are using observer pattern. So that's how it works. If you see example here, so there's a change in 120 rupees. So notified Soros of IBM change to 120 rupees, 121 rupees. So whenever there's a change in price, in stock price, so these two investors are notified. So this IBM is a subject, these investors are observers. So whenever there's a change in subject, these two investors is gonna be notified. This is how the observer pattern will work. Okay, now go to the state pattern. So allows an object to alter behavior when it internal state changes. If you see the example, you could understand it easily. If you see here, right, I said account name is Jim Johnson, the account holder is Jim Johnson, the account holder deposit 500 5500 and they pay interest and withdraw 2000 withdraw 1100. So this is an happen. So whenever you deposit 5,000, balance will be 5,000 and status will be silver state. Then again you deposit 3,000 and balance is 8,000, status is going to be silver state. Again you deposit 5,500, the balance is 1,350, you stay at this gold state. Now see, right, there's a change in state. Again you pay the interest and say this is gold state. Again you withdraw the amount of 2,000, his balance is 582. So now the status is red state. So that's a change in state, right? So that's how it works. Whenever there is a change in our amount, you see this diagram. Okay. This is architecture. Whenever there is a change in context, state gonna be changed. Okay, this is how it works. So this two path, they incorporate this two pattern. The Don, Dan, and we incorporate this two pattern, then cater to the Redux state management. We'll go deeper now. So this is a ES6 code. So whenever we have a big application, whenever we have a large project, an enterprise large scale project, when it comes to maintenance, there comes a problem. So everybody will follow their way of coding style when it comes to HTML and JavaScript. So there comes the problem. So these people think about something called unidirectional flow. From the HTML view, whenever you click an action, the action should be dispatched to the store. So what basically it does, it says, right? So if you see, I created an object. The object name is gonna be, the person is Siva. Give us a contact. Folder, okay. And balance is gonna be 100. So if you wanna change this particular object, you can change directly. But sorry. So we change the object directly. So what they thought is, what the Redux team was thought is, the people who thought is, we want to change a state. The state should be changed to reducers, not directly. The state have to be changed only to reducers and only via actions. If you see here, right? Let me uncomment this code. If you see this code, so I have a reducers. And the state, initial state, and the action is on the switch case. So I'm gonna take the reducers with the empty object, and the action gonna be initiate. So I'm gonna register an object, return an object with number gonna be 0. Okay. So what I'm trying to say is, whenever there is an action, the action should be click add action or subtract action. Whatever it may be, this action have to go to the reducers. There only we need to alter the object. Okay, so that comes to maintain with you, right? So we have a click action. If you click the CSS, this is not the seller action, right? If you click CSS, HTML, EX6 label, this action has to go through the reducers, and the reducers have to do the state management. Now this have to mutate the object. Not we should not directly mutate the object. Okay, so. Okay, let's go to create store.